Hello all, we'll be doing a numerical right now. So I'll read the question. A stationary vane having an inlet angle of 0 degree and an outer angle of 25 degree receives water at a velocity 50 meter per second. Determine the components of force acting on it in the direction of jet velocity and normal to it. Also find the resultant force in the magnitude and direction per kilogram or weight of the or mass of the fluid. Second question, if the vane stated above is moving with a velocity 20 meter per second in the direction of jet, calculate the force components in the direction of vane velocity across it. Also calculate the work done. So you have two questions. In the first case, you have a curved vane, but it is stationary. See, you have a stationary vane. In the second case, it's moving with a velocity 20 meter per second. So the first case, it's a stationary vane. So you have a vane like this and the inlet angle is 0 degree. So if you are having a vane like this, so I'm assuming this is the part through which water is entering and this is the horizontal direction, and with the horizontal direction it's making an angle 0 degree. So the inlet water will be going like this. So this is how your water is coming inside. So that is V1, and it is going out with an outlet angle 25 degree. That means it will be coming out like this, and with the horizontal it is making an angle 25 degrees. So this is the figure. This is how it is working. Now what I do is I'll be resolving this V2 into its components. So if I resolve V2 into its components, this part will be V2 cos 25 degree, and this will be V2 sin 25 degree. And the value for V2 has been given. V2 is equal to 50 meter per second. V2 is equal to 50 meter per second. So this is the equation that we have got. Now, since we have a curved vane, we have got the equation Fx, the force in x direction. So we know that it's equal to rho into q into initial velocity in x direction minus final velocity in x direction. We know that. That is equal to rho into q into initial velocity in x direction. In x direction, the velocity is 50 initial, minus final velocity in x direction is V2 cos 25 towards left side. So we again have negative V2 cos 25 degrees. This negative was already in the equation, and V2 cos 25 is towards left side. So that's why again one more negative. And whatever velocity it's having, the same velocity will be having here, but in a different direction. So V2 will also equal to 50. So that is equal to rho into Q 50 minus plus. And V2 is 50 cos 25 degrees. Here we don't know the value for Q, so we have got a confusion how to find the value for Q. Nothing is given, because for Q we need the area of the nozzle, nothing has been mentioned. So we'll do one thing, see the question. Find the resultant force in magnitude and direction per kilogram of flow. So kilogram means mass. So what you have to find is, you have to find the force per mass. So this is what you have to find, force per mass. And we have seen that force is this thing. Force is nothing but rho into Q. Or rather, I'll write force. You have got this much, and force into mass is nothing but your V1x minus V2x is your force by mass. So this is what you have to find. You have to just find V1x minus V2x to find the force per mass in x direction. So that becomes equal to 50 plus 50 cos 25 degree. Please remember this. To find force per mass, what you have to do is, you have to only think, you are going to cancel this rho into Q. If you cancel this rho into Q, whatever thing is remaining, that is your force per mass. So when you solve it, how much value will you get? So when you solve it, you'll be getting the value for Fx by mass. You'll be getting it as 95.315. So I'll be writing this Fx by m as small fx. Fx is equal to 95.315 newton per kilogram. Newton per kilogram. That's force per mass. Similarly, to calculate the force in y direction, we know that the force in y direction is given by rho into q into initial velocity in y direction minus final velocity in y direction. It is equal to rho into q. The initial velocity in y direction. Initial, the force is all the velocities in x direction. There's no component in y direction, so that is 0. Minus the component of velocity at the exit in the y direction, that is V2 sine 25 degree. And again, one more thing, you have to calculate what you have to find the force per mass. So you can cancel this rho dq. So that becomes 0 minus V2 sine 25. So that you will be getting it as, when you substitute V2 value is 50, when you substitute, you will be getting the value as minus 21.13 Newton per kilogram. So you got Fx and Fy. This is small Fy. And to calculate the resultant force F is equal to Fx square plus Fy square. And if you substitute, you will be getting the value as 97.63 Newton per kilogram. So you have got the force per unit weight or unit mass of that. And to calculate the angle, see your force, if you see Fx is positive, that means it is acting in this direction, and Fy is negative, it means it is acting in this direction. So you have Fy like this and you have Fx like this. So this is your resultant F. Now to calculate the angle alpha, this is the angle alpha. Alpha is given by tan inverse of Fy by Fx. If you substitute the value, you will be getting alpha as 0.3. Angle is 12.5 degrees. Now coming to the second part of the question, what happens if the whole vane is moving with the velocity? It's having a velocity in this direction. That velocity is 20 meter per second. U is equal to 20 meter per second. That's the case, you have a relative velocity case. So we can write the force in x direction is equal to rho into q into the relative velocity, initial velocity, vr1 in x direction minus vr2 in x direction. Since earlier it was v1x and v2x, here we have to calculate the relative velocity in x and y direction. So in initial and final condition. And here also what you have to calculate is, you have to calculate the force per mass. So force per mass, you can cancel this rho into q. So this is vr1x minus vr2x. Now see the resultant velocity here. You have a velocity here and you have a component u in this direction. So there's a simple way that you can remember. In the earlier case, wherever you have substituted v, this has to be replaced by v minus u. So what happens here? What is the initial velocity here? Earlier the velocity was 50. Now what will be, this has to be substituted 50 minus 20. So that was the velocity. So I can say that the vr1, the relative velocity vr1 is equal to what I can write, v minus the relative velocity. I'm just writing vr, the relative velocity vr is equal to v minus u, is equal to 50 minus 20, that is equal to 30 meter per second. So instead of putting 50, what you have to say is this velocity. Initially it will be entering here with the relative velocity. I'll be writing the relative velocity is equal to 30 meter per second. So that is the velocity with which it is entering. It is also leaving with the relative velocity vr is equal to 30 meter per second, because the relative velocity is equal to v minus u, that is 30 meter per second. Now if I substitute, fx by m is equal to small fx. So that is equal to, I say, the relative velocity in the x direction. Initially what is the relative velocity in x direction? That is 30 itself. 30 minus, what is the relative velocity at the second point in x direction? The relative velocity with which it is coming out is 30. And the component of 30 towards this x direction will be 30 cos 25. So I'll be writing a different, this is the relative velocity vr cos 25, because this, we are not dealing with the case of stationary, we are dealing with stationary. Sorry, we are dealing with the moving vane. So we have to consider vr, vr is equal to, and vr in x direction is equal to vr cos 25, that is acting in the left, towards the left side. So minus vr is 30 cos 25 degree. So when you find the value, you will be getting fx is equal to 57.19 Newton per kilogram. Similarly, you can find the value for Fy. Fy is rho into q into the relative velocity in x direction, initial minus, x direction, y direction, minus vr2 in y direction. This you can write. And I need to find Fy by mass, so that is small Fy. That can be written as, after cancelling rho into q, VR1 minus VR2. Now what is the initial relative velocity, that is PR? What is its component in y direction? There's no component, so that is 0. Now what's the final relative velocity, that is 30? What's its component in this direction? So that will be VR sine 20. Because the relative velocity is 30, and the component in y direction is VR sine 25. It's acting towards up, so that will be positive. So that is VR 30 sine 25. So that you'll be getting the value of Fy as minus 12.67 Newton per kilometer. So after getting Fx and Fy, you know how to calculate the resultant. F is given by root of Fx square plus Fy square. And you'll be getting the value as 58.57 Newton. Fx is acting towards this direction. Fy is acting towards this direction. So your resultant is something like this. This angle is alpha. So alpha is equal to tan inverse of Fy by Fx. You'll be getting the value of alpha as 12.5 degree itself. So you'll be getting this much. Now the major thing that you have to calculate is you have to calculate the work done. So work done. See, it is moving in u direction. So in order to move in this direction, in the x direction, the force that it should be acting should be force in x direction. So the work done. So the work done should be equal to Fx into u. Work done per unit time is equal to Fx into, because u is in x direction, so the force that should be acting also should be in Fx direction, not Fy, because it is moving in u direction. So you know the value for Fx, what was the value for Fx? All they calculated, in this case the value of Fx was equal to 57.19. And you know the velocity in x direction, that is 20 meter. So multiply by 20. So you'll be getting the answer 1143.8 Newton meter per second. You'll be getting the value like this. So this is how you calculate the forces acting and the work done.